in a key matchup here between the Wasteland Athletic Conference's Leaping Lizard, who is hosting the new to the MML Pro League this year, Solus Sabres, headed up by Coach CHASEJJ. And as Coach Chase was just commenting on the sideline, there has been an interesting start to this game, and we're just tuning in. Coach Chase, if you are hearing this, what do you mean? What did you mean by that?
Nothing must be holding him up.
Wow. So it's violent. Teams are out for blood. As those of you who follow the MML closely may know, Leaping Lizard last week took a serious beating from a Wood Elf team, the Leaf Dancers, and they are missing a couple of players. One of them, their star skink, Billy, who is out, and in his absence, Ricky, who has really stepped up this year and is almost looked at as the future of the franchise. As far as the skinks go anyway, we know Coach Don Eagle does not... He really puts the meat of his stock in the Sorai, but even he can't deny that Billy has been a key player for his team. So missing him this match is definitely going to come into effect in some respect. And if an opportunity exists to take advantage of holes on offense for the Solus Sabres, missing Billy is probably helping that.
They should hire a tame player.
Like some of the broadcasts, because I am required to multitask at this time, I will not be talking about every play at every time. But I will be jumping in at least for the key plays. And if we were talking about keys, well, let's say the keys for Leaping Lizard, like I said, would have been Billy. Him missing is a big deal. But really, Leaping Lizard, if you were to ask Coach Don, I'm sure Coach Don Eagle would say that his key player really is a Saurus known to everyone as Wade. Wade has started off this year on fire with 9 casualties already and only 3 matches played. I'm trying to find him on the pitch, but I can't, and that is because he's laying on the ground. I don't know if that's from a pylon. I think that's probably from a pylon, as Coach Chase mentioned earlier.
That's a solid formation. I want to see the opposing team have a go at the ball.
Now, it looks like the Solus Sabres received the ball because we're in the top of the second, and they are still going. And man, there's people all over this pitch. So if we set the key for Don Eagle is Wade, and by the way, Wade is a Saurus who is, he's not their strongest player by far. Don Eagle's Leaping Lizard is characterized by 3 big strength 5 players. One of them, again, is a Croxagore, and that's Hodor. But you also have Snake, who's immensely strong, and you have Kano, who's standing. You see all 3 of those guys just crowding up the middle of the pitch over there and plugging it up. So you see the Solus Sabres kind of trying to sneak over to the side there and make it so that only the Skinks are able to try and engage them. So if the keys for Leaping Lizard's offense, or team rather, is Wade and the 3 strength 5 players, then I would say that having looked at Coach CHASEJJ's team and agreeing with his assessment, he stated this out loud before, his keys to his team probably reside in his ulfs. The werewolves are Kelvin, who is knocked to the ground by Hodor, and Mad Magnus Isaac, who is a vicious werewolf that likes to pile on, and he's got a mean right hook with a mighty blow. And Oliver, a relatively young Saurus, is going to run up and knock back Regin Katla. Last week being a really bad one for Leaping Lizard, as I said. They lost Oliver. He was dead last week. So the explanation from Coach Don Eagle has not come up as to who this new Oliver is, if there's any relation to the old Oliver. But, ouch. And this is what Wade does. Wade is a frenzied Solus. He gets going and you just can't stop him. Pushes back Marquis into the crowd. The crowd starts to pummel him on the head and shoulders, and Marquis is going to be knocked out. The crowd then throws the ball in. It bounces all over the place, and it is ending up on the right side of the pitch within reach of Wazmikshi, who grabs that ball and runs away. He is a mercenary come into play for this game, as Lizzie the Third was injured in the last game, and Billy is missing as well. And now the rest of the Sora are just going to clean up the field. So it looks like Leaping Lizard having something to prove after getting beaten up really badly, and they're just laying people out. Similar situation when TMNL got beat up a couple of weeks ago pretty badly by Ye Yobs. They came back the next week and really laid a whooping physically on the Skaven last week, and that was the Rodentia ad nauseum. Now, they physically beat him up, but the game came to a draw. So that holds some promise for Chase, that even if these lizards are going to come out violent, maybe they get more concerned with beating people up and lose sight of actually closing the deal and winning the game.
Up, up, and away.
So Toby jumps up. You have to wonder if Coach Chase forgot that Toby has the ability to jump up from the ground and immediately strike, because it almost seemed like a wasted opportunity to take a swing. Or maybe I'm wondering if he didn't want to risk. Gotcha. But you ended up making the die, the block anyway with Regenfrere. You ended up going one die on it with Regenfrere, and you're doing it now. Again with Galt. Gotcha. Okay. And Coach Don got away with Wade sitting on that sideline like that. That could have been disastrous.
Unity is strength. Will the big one manage to lay out an opponent of half his strength?
There we go. So I look down for a second and I see Agni Krofnarsson all up in Wazmikshi's face. I didn't notice that that's where he ended last turn. So Coach Don still has not done anything about that. He's got a couple of options, because he gets an automatic reroll if he fails to dodge away from the person marking him, even with the journeyman. Or he could try to pass it over to Mini. Let Mini try to do something. But I bet we'll probably just see a dodge away if there's not a blitz to free up the loner. Nope, blitz has just been used. I'm sorry, so there will not be a blitz. It looks like the loner's going to make a break for the touchdown. So, and if the loner scores a touchdown and gains some SPP, I wonder if we will be seeing Wazmikshi kind of carve their place out here in the on the Leaping Lizard. Looks like we've lost Coach Chase. He finally got a mic. It was cool to hear him. So maybe he jumps back on. I don't know. Something weird is happening. I wonder if something's frozen or something, because Coach Don is leaving Wes McShee in contact. And now this is strange. I wonder if it's just our crystal ball. Very, very weird.
On balance, I prefer the passing game to running down the field. One tactic is intellectual elite.
Coach Don Eagle asking what's going on. The timer is frozen on my screen, Don. I don't think he rage quit because he abruptly left my party as well. So I don't know if he lost connection. But I'm seeing 000 on the timer for Don. So it hasn't switched over. Okay. See, I'm not even seeing the countdown. I'm seeing 0000. So maybe it'll fix itself once that whole thing works itself out. But I'm guessing the internet loss because he dipped out of my party as well. It'd be a shame.
It's another handoff.
Okay, I'm seeing Don's stuff showing up now.
Ball transmitted.
So it looks like the ball was successfully passed to Mini, who bobbled it. Mini runs, bolts toward the Solus Sabres end zone. And I'm guessing we're going to see the Sorai shore up all of those possible avenues of approach. Oliver taking a swing at Galt. And you're going to see Ricky break away, get in the vicinity of Mini. It looks like he's going to lay some blocking action there. Slade is going to come over. Silly's gonna come over and mark the down Olaf Formor.
Ooh.
Arachnus, Lord of Spiders, tries to get up, but then just starts going berserk and growling and scratching his armpits and biting out his own fur. So it looks like Galt is gonna go up and mark Wade. And he's actually going to just set Wade up for the clothesline from Kelvin. Kelvin knocking Wade to the ground. And where is he going to go from there? So it looks like a couple of MML members have found the game. They found the Twitch. And they are relieved that they have something to distract them from the rigors of being asked to do stuff at work. That's right, the MML, where we distract you from doing stuff you really need to do all day. Welcome.
Fans are furious.
All right, so turnover happens, and you're going to see Minnie bolt for that sideline, or for that end zone. She could score, but she decides to just hold up tight, and there goes Ricky to make sure nobody gets within range, even if they wanted to. They'd be unable to do so. They'd only be able to touch Ricky. So When the team full of such high value armor, you really, really, really need Arachnus, Lord of Spiders, to step up. And so far, I have not seen a lot of action out of him this match.
That's quite a mismatch, Bob.
I know. That weedy fella's gonna get
stuck. So it looks like we had some communication problems for a little earlier on between Coach Chase and his players. We had some telecom issues that had to get worked out, but they were solved now because it looks like we're full speed ahead with this game. Crowd calling for blood, smash to Mankini Brigade. The Norse are one of those teams that I think inspires strong feelings one way or the other. You either love them or you hate them. And Wade taking a swing at Galt, who is an experienced guard berserker. Both of these competitors are skilled in the art of frenzy attacks. This time, Wade is unable to put Galt down. But he does push him back farther away from the skinks, meaning that the delay will continue for longer, potentially. Kano knocking back Agni Krafnerson. And Wasmikshi, who had the ball before, not gotten the chance to touch it anymore. Standing around waiting to see how she can get involved, or he can get involved. Nice, Silly breaks contact. Puts himself out of reach from Olaf. And it looks like the Solus Sabres are more concerned with getting in their hits than they are with stopping the ball. I guess the touchdown is a foregone conclusion, and they're not going to try to get the Lizards to score early. And here comes Arachnus. Arachnus making his mark. His claws are deadly. Blake is stunned. That's a big deal. And he's going to hold tight, standing over Blake. And here comes Mad Magnus, who is going to push back Kano and push him into Arachnus, which is definitely a threat for the next turn. Kelvin taking swings at Slade, and the second swing fells him, and he's going to pile on. This is what Kelvin likes to do, and Slade is knocked out.
If you look very carefully, you
for anyone who has coached Lizards or who plays against Lizards, they know that every Sorai that goes out is a big deal. This is not like other teams where you can afford to lose a lineman and say whatevs. You lose a Saurus, it could really affect your play. However, fortunately for Coach Don, that was one of the least important Sorai. But that is not. And Regenfrayer coming up with a big headbutt against Wade, and Wade is stunned. Laying there on the pitch, he has no clue where he is. Galt tries the same madness with Snake, and Snake gives him the business. Smacks him down. Says, I don't know what time you thought this was, but it's hammer time, and he hammers him to the ground. That's right, I just did that. Shame on me. Now we're going to see Lippin Lizard react. Are we going to see some hits against the AV7, or are we going to see Mini trot into the end zone and probably set herself up for some good training and experience this week, which will add to her tool belt. Regenfrayer is knocked the hell out by Snake. We'll run up and make contact with Isaac, Olaf, and Agni. This could mean that Kano is going to fight his way away from Arachnus. No, instead, he's going to take a swing at Arachnus. Only manages to push him back. No, he's actually just going to let him sit there. Push him away. Smart move. They stay in contact with this trio of Norse teammates who are now looking like they realize that the situation has flipped on them a little bit. They definitely had the numbers and the strength, and that is quickly changing as Oliver comes over and he's staring down Isaac in the face. Some coaches would not want to carry on like this, but potentially Coach Don Eagle sees this as a tactical mistake by Coach Chase, and he is going to definitely roll up his sleeves, and his team is going to mix it up. And there goes the backhand, and Toby is dead! Laying on the ground, he is dead. Toby, a very important berserker. We talked about how important the Ulfs were for this team, and it looks like Coach Chase is saving the Apo. He waves the Apo off, and he is going to let Toby die. And I would say that having scoured this team, that if there was one player who was not a werewolf on this team, who was crucial to it, or who was definitely worth using this Apo on, it would have been Toby. But that's just Coach Chase saying, nope, the Apo is definitely just for my Ulfs. Who knows, maybe for his Yeti too. We haven't encountered that situation. And there goes Silly. KO'd. Knock the hell out. Bring out Chris Tucker, because you got knocked the hell out, man. And Arachnus is going to go skink hunting as well. Unsuccessfully, the journeyman skink, Wask McShees, able to avoid getting flattened. Seston says, dead Norse better than a dead war dancer. No, I like to see war dancers die more than definitely than any Norse player. I would disagree with that, Coach Seston. You probably just don't deal with enough war dancers making your life hell. And just like that, Oliver is knocked out. Again, Oliver, having been killed last week by the Leaf Dancers, and I'm wondering who this imposter is. Calling himself Oliver. Maybe Coach Don Eagle can explain that to us later after the game. Ouch. There is an attempted dodge by Galt to get away from Hodor, and Hodor gives him the tail and sweeps his feet out from under him. Yeah. This is an exciting match. Both sides coming out swinging. The Lizards did not back down. They expected Coach CHASEJJ to come out and swing and foul. We really haven't seen a lot of fouling from the Solus Sabres, which is surprising. But in the Solus Sabres' favor, two Sorai are out. So this match, if they stay out, this match could end up changing as this numbers advantage starts to spin. And you have Agni, who has not been afraid of contact all day, take a swipe at Snake to no avail. And here comes the Sorai Triangle. The Saurus Triangle, rather. Blake is going to come in and solidify their locking them down. And because the person or the player in control of the ball is Mini, who is a leaping lizard player, you have to believe that next round is going to be very painful for Agni and Olaf. There's not much they can do about it. And it looks like Ricky's going to come over to help, and he is going to mark up Kelvin. Most coaches would probably be very, very, very careful about using a movement 9 skink because they're so valuable. But Coach Don Eagle does not care. His skinks are replaceable. And look at that! Kelvin giving Wade the business! Wade is flattened again. Wade came into this match with 9 casualties in 3 matches. He has been an absolute terror. But this time, he may have met his match on this pitch. Kelvin coming in and doing some damage. And is Leaping Lizard going to wait till next turn to score? I mean, Yeah, are they going to wait? Are they going to score in turn 7, or will they score in turn 8? It probably depends on what the Solus Sabres do this round. And you're going to see a hard hit from Arachnus. His claws really unnecessary and don't amount to... There's diminishing returns as they're used on Skinks. Magnus Isaac takes a swing at Kano, and they just have a Mexican standoff over there. And Kelvin is going to take a red die swipe at Kano and knock him to the deck and then pile on. Oh, Kelvin is on fire. He's laying people out left and right.
That's going to be a turn.
Olaf presses his luck. And that was Blake. Blake is not trying to hear it. Smacks Olaf down. Right now, Coach Don trying to figure out. Yep, he tells his Sorai, keep pounding. Keep pounding. We're in a fight. They want to fight. We're going to fight. Snake knocking down Magnus. Both Ulfs on the deck right now. You have to wonder if there's going to be a foul. Hodor looking down at two hapless Norsemen.
Quite a mismatch, Bob.
I know.
Trying to figure out what he wants to do here. Kano taking a swipe at Gali, but he is unable to lay him out. And here comes Hodor, knocking him to the deck. These Norse have been pretty resilient. One of them thrown out for fouling. One of them is dead. Don Eagle says, enough is enough. Let's score right now. Board saying, you like when I clip my mic? Well, it's announcing I clip my mic. I don't think it's clipped. I'm using a headset. Not sure I know what you mean, but hopefully it's a good thing. And we have our first score of the game. That's Minnie. And Minnie, again, gaining valuable experience there. Something tells me we're going to see her come back next week, having learned a couple of tricks here and there. A trick or two, you know.
That player before they lose any more.
Despite being in the lead, this team now has to kick the ball to the losing squad.
All right.
They get it back.
So, Coach Don leaving Chase with enough room to receive. And both teams gain a turn as there is trash talking between two of the players, and it turns into a full-scale riot. Ladies and gentlemen, it looked like Wade and Kelvin were screaming at each other on the pitch. Wade from the sideline, actually, laying there.
What's happening down there?
He is still kind of out of it. He's on the sideline yelling at Kelvin, I'm going to get you, sucker. Doesn't seem to really know where he is, though. And Kelvin flipping him off. Ah, gotcha. So then I'm taking it that the clipping, your liking of the clipping is sarcasm then. I will try not to clip. Maybe pull the mic away. And there goes Kelvin, piling on. Good stuff. All right. Well, I'll still make it organic, though. I can't help getting excited, guys. This kind of match, this one's fun to watch. It's fun to announce. These two teams really going at each other's throats. And for those of you that know, these two coaches are no strangers to each other. Coach Don and Coach Chase have definitely played each other on the farm more than once. And let's just say that Coach Don has made very clear that he does not approve of certain tactics that Coach JJ uses on the farm. Some harsh words have been exchanged. Dare I say, I believe that these two don't really play on the farm anymore. I think Coach Don prefers not to play against Chase on the farm, but I think he's trying to make a statement here. in the pros. I think he's relishing this opportunity to beat up Chase's team here when it matters. Good stuff, guys. I'm glad you enjoy it. Yeah, definitely announcing these matches and matches like this is, we've said this time and again, but it's almost more fun announcing. It may be more. It actually is. Now, you know, being TMNL's coach, it actually is more fun announcing than it is being the coach on the field. Because you don't have to deal. When crazy stuff happens, it's not happening to you. So you can just enjoy it. And I've been on the receiving end of way too many bad dice rolls to really enjoy those situations as the coach. But this is sure as hell fun to watch. And the ball is just laying there. Chase leaving it there. And this is a dangerous situation. When you have a squad that can cover as much ground as these skinks can. Yeah, it is very dangerous. And as Coach Borbot says in the chat, advanced lizards are a brutal matchup for the Norse. Yes. And these are definitely advanced lizards. We're talking about very strong Soras, Sorai here. And there goes Hodor trying to give Galt a little pound to the head. And it does not work out. Galt standing his ground. He's been very tough. This young berserker's really shown a lot of metal and moxie, if you ask me. And look at that silly running up and eyeing that ball like it's a steak dinner. And there's nothing more than skinks like than to savor up a nice, juicy steak dinner. You got Oliver on the left side of the pitch taking a look at that ball laying there between the two Norsemen. And to him, that's just got to look like that paper that you run through when you're running out onto the field. Very thin and just smashable. So he's going to run up, say hello. Oliver whispering a little sweet nothings over to Scalabera. Looks like he wants to. He's trying to intimidate him over there. And look at that. The journeyman, Uazmik, who's been making his presence felt, runs up and he's within range. Here come all the skinks. This is the thing about skinks, man. They can really swarm an area and cause problems for you. So not only are they threatening to grab that ball and potentially run it in, but they are also serving as a blocker, if you will, or a defensive obstacle, rather, so that any of those Norsemen that decide that they want to try to pick up that ball and run past them and throw it or something are unable to. But it doesn't matter because no Norsemen are within range anyway, so you'd have to have some serious chain pushing to get your guy where they want to go, but I just don't think they even have. I don't think that's even possible given the setup here on the field. So if Coach Chase is smart about this, we will see him try to, you know, turtle up and not let his team go down 2-0. Before the end of the half, and you are going to see Arachnus run over and knock Blake down. It's a big deal, and then stand over him laughing. And again, man, Coach Chase is not shy about telling his Norsemen to take swipes at people that are a lot bigger than them. They just don't care. But a lot of times it is not working out. The snake ain't having none of that. Knocking down Laurent to the ground, and we are gonna see Kelvin hold his own again. Kelvin has been a monster. It is arguable that he may single-handedly just be holding down the Solus Sabres and keeping it from getting ugly, because he has been violent and just downright mean in this matchup. Look at that, Slade with a right hook. Agni goes down. This ball is very, very retrievable. And if there's a short list of coaches on the pitch that you would trust with trying to get this ball right now in this situation and turning it into a score, Don Eagle would definitely be on that short list of coaches that you would believe could make that happen. Players fit.
Jest is approximately the same size as his entire opponent.
And you're going to see Oliver push Scalabero away from the ball. Only one more Norseman to clear away from the vicinity of the ball. And the person to do it may be Blake. That may be the player to do it, and that's what he does. He gets up, and at first it looks like he is unable to knock the Norseman down, but he does successfully knock him down. That extra training he put in this week on the heavy bag really helped out. And now this is going to get interesting.
He's sprinting.
Wow! He's able to pick the ball up and charge into the end zone. And this is now turning into a disaster. Minnie for her second touchdown. She is all of a sudden a monster. Coming into this matchup, you would have said that the star skink was definitely Billy on the squad and Ricky was the wave of the future, but Minnie just coming out of nowhere, really showing some real moxie. This young lady, we're going to be seeing some great things out of her, I can tell. Well, as long as she lasts anyway, because if you're a skink and you play for Don Eagle, your career is in jeopardy on a regular basis. So it looks like Wade gets up, and that is bad news for the Norse. And this is going toward ugly.
Looks like that apothecary's magic.
Especially because Leaping Lizard gets the ball back. So I would be very surprised to see a comeback at this point.
The best defense is a good offense. Or the other way around.
I'd be very surprised to see them tie it up. And I think what may end up happening, especially with these depleted numbers continuing, is that you may start to see the Solar Sabres just fighting to try to stay somewhat healthy. Because all of the Leaping Lizard is back on the pitch, and there are three Norse off the pitch. This is rough. And it looks like we have Coach Chase on the comms right now. Chase, you have a second on the sideline to tell us what you're thinking? You never can tell with those apothecaries. And oh, gosh, to add insult to injury, Olaf suffers an injury from a rock thrown from the crowd. As you know, we are at the Leaping Lizard Stadium. So, that's what sucks when you're the visiting team. And look who couldn't wait to get off the sideline. He is just viciously pursuing this Norse lineman, Scalabera. Wade all up in his face, but maybe he's still shaking off the cobwebs and unable to knock down Scalabera. This is when you're going to... Yeah, I was very surprised when you chose not to do that. I guess the policy is the Apo is strictly for the Ulfs, huh? Gotcha. Okay. Makes sense. And you're going to have Oliver start to get into place. Yeah, Leaping Lizard getting pretty aggressive, and this is looking like it could get quickly out of hand. So the chat is saying they can't hear you, Coach Chase, and it may be because you don't have your party settings enabled to be allow voice to be shared. Obviously, don't worry about it if it's going to interfere with your playing at all. I'll just pass along what you said. But if you do get the chance to fix the settings, that's what we got going on. All right, and Lizard's getting pretty aggressive, sending everybody midfield. Ooh, Ricky going to pick up the ball, and again, where once Kick's fortune is looking bright, and that's Minnie, who has really showed some real talent here today. Ricky fumbling the ball. Now, in this circumstance, it really doesn't matter. There are no Norse near the ball, and this is probably the smart thing to do here on the Solar Saver side. They are going to use their Yeti with his nasty, dangerous claws to come down and knock Wade to the pitch. And then he's going to stand over him. Man, there's been a lot of desperation blocks here. I guess I understand it because there's so many strength 5 players, but the statistics wise, it doesn't seem to be the smartest play, but it may just be a matter of not really having a lot of choices. That is the problem when you are a bashy coach and you run into a team that is just naturally bashier than you are and they have more strength. You have to be able to adapt to the dodging game, I think. And if you can't, then what's happening here starts to happen. And, that is tough. Wade gets up. It looked like he was going to be unable to complete that block against Arachnus, but again, the extra training on the heavy bag kicked in, and he's able to knock Arachnus down. He tries to pile on to make sure Arachnus stays down. Doesn't have a lot of effect. That Yeti's going to get up soon. I did not catch whether there were inducements, if there was a TV difference. Again, if we still have you on comms, Coach Chase, was there a TV difference? Were there inducements? There was a bribe? Okay, so that was it. So there's enough difference for a bribe. And that's it. Wow. A bribe, and there has been a Norse player ejected since, like, the beginning of the game. The dirty player is gone. And that was probably a big key difference here. So obviously there were probably two fouls. One bribe was used and he was thrown out. And ouch! Coach Don Eagle says to Chase, I'm going to show you how to foul. And they come over and they foul Arachnus. And Silly sent off for that. But at this point, Coach Don Eagle does not really care. Now, this is where the Apo came in and actually kept Arachnus from leaving the game. He's done a little Mr. Miyagi action over there. And look at that. Coach Shots must favor his little brother Chase. Sent him over a really good Apo. But now Arachnus over on the sideline, angry, snarling, pissed off that he's not on the pitch. And, to be honest, if the Solus Savers want to have a good chance of avoiding further injury or maybe taking out some of these Sorai again, they're going to need to score, or force Sleeping Lizard to score to get that Yeti back on the pitch. Because right now, if I'm Don Eagle, I probably am going to hold off on scoring a third touchdown, even if I have the opportunity, just because I don't want that Yeti and his stupid claws back on the pitch. But Isaac coming up big. Remember, I told you the keys for Solar Savers have actually been their ulfs. And Isaac with a big hit on Slade, and he's going to silence him for a couple turns. Where is Kelvin, who has been pretty quiet this half? Kelvin standing right next to Slade. And up! Coach Chase reminded about what his bread and butter is. And we can see what's probably going to happen next turn. Oh, no, it's going to happen this turn. And Slade is injured. Coach Don Eagle can't be happy about that. I don't see what happened there because it happened so quickly. The Apple came over to do work, and obviously it looks like he was unable to keep him in the match. We will see Slade remain out for the rest of the match. So that's not good for Don. He went in for... it was a bribe for Don that went out. Gotcha. Okay. Nice. I just noticed that. Wow, so Solus Savers actually has the higher TV. Surprising with all the strength upgrades. There's the bonehead from Hodor. I wonder if that's what Kami put, most likely a BH. Did he just predict the bonehead from the Crocs? From the Croc? All right, you're gonna see. Oh, badly hurt. Okay, gotcha. I was gonna say, how the hell? Oliver runs over, gets in Regan's face, and you're gonna see Kano, run back down, and looks like they're setting up a cage for Ricky to get in the cage, and Ricky fumbles the ball again. Coach Don has had enough. Yells at him to focus and think about the extra training he put in this week. Yeah, if you could have predicted that, I would have called BS on this random generator. I said, come on, man. Ain't no random generator. And Isaac is not done. So it's been a tale of two halves for the Wolves. Funny, the first one, it was definitely Kelvin. And now we're seeing Isaac come in and wreck some damage. And it looks like the Solus Savers at this point are just trying to salvage some pride. Again, Isaac piling on Blake. I personally am not a fan of piling on to a stun. It's because I feel like you've already got some type of armor break and result, and piling on puts your guy on the ground. But I guess if you're determined to make sure he stays out no matter what, then you do what Coach Chase is doing now.
Come on.
Wow, he's taking sprints and strides to do what he needs to do. And here comes the dirty hit on Blake, who is injured. He's just badly hurt, and Agni is thrown out. But that is a trade-off I think anybody watching this match would easily make. Get rid of Blake at the expense of one of your Norsemen. That is fine with Coach Chase, I would bet. And there goes Ricky, sprinting up the sideline. Looks like Coach Don, by any means necessary, wants to get him his experience. Yeah, I figured that. And I guess Coach Don could probably thank his lucky stars that Coach Chase hasn't managed to injure one of the five strengths, Sorai, because, you know, or the Crocs, because those are really his bread and butter, them and Wade. So. Right, Seston, yeah. Definitely if your opponent's not a Fowler, but in this case, there's no way I'd be. Not no way. I'm just saying I would be leery of, if I've got a stun, I wouldn't throw a guy down around a Norse team who is obviously intent on ruining my victory, making it bittersweet. And Regan Frere is KO'd. Hodor showing him what his jaws look like. And that number of Norse on the field is just dwindling. Here comes Kelvin. And Kelvin is going to successfully knock Oliver down. Are we going to see the pylon? He is skilled at piling on. Are we going to see it, though? No, we're not. And I bet you what we are going to see, though. I bet you I know what we are going to see. I'm a little curious why he did it. Okay, ended up the same way. Oliver stunned.
I hope that ref is handy with an axe.
And Mord is thrown out. And I see the strategy, but it is starting with the number of Norse being thrown out. It's starting to not make sense for the Solus Sabres. We already have 1, 2, 3 Norsemen ejected. That is actually, that ties the MML record for ejections at 3. And Hodor is looking around stupid. No clue what's going on. Sometimes he's just off in his own little world like that. Yeah, the chat is saying that Chase is going to pitch clear himself by fouling. And look at that, Wade knocking Scalabera down and then piles on. Ricky looking over at his coach asking, what do I do, coach? Do I score or what? I don't think Coach Don's going to tell him to score, but maybe, I don't know. At this point, maybe he wants to farm SPP and try to get a score of 4 or something, I don't know. Definitely has a numbers advantage coming back. So look at that. So is that, that's Mini coming back. And Kano taking a swipe at Galt. Pushing him back. And what is Ricky going to do here? Ricky's over there screwing around in the middle of the field. Dancing by himself. And honestly, Coach Chase isn't even looking in his direction. He does not seem to care at all. And Minnie, who has been great this match, is knocked to the ground violently. And she's knocked out. At this point, it doesn't really matter. If you're not injuring Lizard Man at this point, it doesn't mean anything. But she's off the pitch, so never know. But as each turn passes, it just really doesn't matter. Kelvin tries to take a swing at Kano, but is unsuccessful, and Kano bats him down. Says, you may have been beating up Wade earlier, but I ain't Wade, I'm stronger. Yep, some of the chat questioning the tactical wisdom in having blitzed and then decided to pile on. I can only guess that Coach Chase just probably was banking on injuring the skink the first time around and then continuing to move to where he needed to move. And here comes Hodor. Hodor, a skilled guard, and he's going to put a tackle zone on Galt, and Kano unable to floor Galt. That's got to be frustrating. But man, you've got 1, 2, 3, 4. You only got 4, 6 Norse left, and you got 6 Lizardmen as well. So, and you got Ricky just sitting there in the middle of the field.
Unity is strength.
There goes Wade. Successful hit. He is going to injure Loran the Stout, who's badly hurt. So really the only devastating injury that I've seen so far in this match is the death of Toby. And look at this. Ricky is running in circles, literally running in circles in the middle of the field. He's got one claw behind his head. He's extending the ball out. He's singing something. I can't see what he's singing, but he is just disrespecting the Norsemen. Well, he would be disrespecting the Norsemen, except the Norsemen just really don't seem to care. They are making crazy blocks, just trying to land one wherever they can. The Lizards are easily sidestepping those blows and smacking them down. And this is a serious drubbing right now. This is an ass whooping.
This is going to be decisive.
Oliver getting in the mix. Stu thinks Chase will throw his controller. I don't. I think Chase enjoys the fight more than anything. This has definitely been a fight. This is at this game was over at the end of the first half, and the rest of it has basically just been an angry fight, one side being pissed off, and ouch. There you go, Wade knocking Galt to the ground. Galt, again, just has been so tough this match. He has been swung at by every lizard. They don't like his guarding ability, and they just continue to take swings at him, but he just keeps getting up. Scalabero won't get up, though. I think he's done for the... No, he'll get up in turn 16. But he's done for next turn. He doesn't really know where he is. He is scrambling around on the ground. At one point, he tried to get up the wrong way and knocked his head into the ground. And look, the fouls are on. This is where you know you don't care. Coach Don Eagle, it's all about blood now. He is fouling with his five strength swords. I haven't seen something like this in a while. And ouch, the hits just keep on coming. The fight looks like it's completely gone out of the Norse. They only have one player left standing, and he is alone and unafraid. That's Isaac sitting in the middle of the pitch, staring down Hodor, and behind him is Kano, and Coach Don Eagle is just going to score. He's just going to score. He's going to make sure he gets that third score. And that is gonna do it for the match, except you're gonna get to see Chase try to get a one-turn touchdown. Maybe I don't think he has enough personnel for it. Yeah, it would have been cool to see a Crocs foul stew. But this has been ugly. Dead and injured. Four lizard men. And look at that, five out. Again, tying the league record for ejections is Chase. Who knows? He's still got one turn, though. So, you may see the Solus Sabres set the record with four fouls. And this is gangster right here. Coach Don Eagle is just going to put his skinks up on the line and say, screw it. And that's including Ricky, who is one of the fastest players in the league, being able to cover basically 18 yards in one turn. That's before he pushes himself. And look at that. The weather changes. It's pouring rain all of a sudden. And the storm clouds that are coming down and the weeping rain has to reflect what's going on in Chase's heart right now. And they let Ricky have it. And that is that costly or no? He's just stunned. But here comes the pylon. And nothing. Nothing. So... whereas the Norse came out kind of mean, once they were kind of put out of this game, you saw kind of a more defeated tone. Let's see if Calvin can finish off Wasmiksha. And he knocks him out. He knocks him out and then piles on. I don't understand that.
If I had a gold crown for
every... Okay, so he cancels out the knockout.
Well, I could start.
I mean, he's just trying to farm SPP at this point, I guess. And a nasty blow by Arachnus. It's just a stun, though. None of these hits are getting the SPP that Coach Chase was hoping for. And it looks like they are going to try to make Coach Don Eagle pay for putting his movement 9 skink on the line. Are we seeing the end of Ricky? I'm kind of hoping. Oh, Ricky is injured! And Coach Chase may get the final middle finger. No, he does not. It's just a badly hurt. And he wasn't thrown out, so he doesn't get the league record for expulsions. You are now seeing, so you're seeing the final score here. 3-0, Leaping Lizard. It's basically been a drumming. However, what's crazy is there were 23 armor breaks from the Solus Sabres. So 23 falls, 3 short of the league record of 26. This was a very entertaining match for being one that was out of hand really quickly. I mean, we've seen, that's 5 expulsions. That might be a record in total expulsions. I don't know, but that's pretty damn high. I don't remember seeing any game off the top of my head that has involved 3 players getting thrown out on one side and 2 on the other. and 23 armor breaks from the Solus Sabers. That's significant. If you take a look at these stats, Leaping Lizard had this ball in hand most of the way through. 75% possession, 62% occupation of opponent's half. Being completely honest, we don't really know what that stat means. We've been asking Cyanide, but it's not a record anyway. The record's 75%. Any other interesting stats here? I mean, both sides putting up over 50 blocks. 4 KOs from the Solus Sabers, 134 rushing from Leaping Lizard. That's pretty good. It's not a league record. It's good though. It's significant. This has just been, it's been a good match. Coach Chase, are you still around? All right, it looks like we do not have Coach Chase on the line. I'm not sure if Coach Don Eagle is on. I sent him a chat invite earlier. I'd like to get the post-game interview with him, but if he is unable to and we can't get him, we're just going to sign off. For all of you in the chat, you know, thanks for joining us. I hope you were as entertained with this match as I was. It was definitely entertaining. This was a street fight. I loved every minute of it. Thanks for letting me announce, guys. And oh, looks like we just had Coach Don Eagle join us on the sideline. Yeah. Yes, sir. How you doing?
Yeah, I did want to chat during the game.
Yeah, of course, of course. If you can you turn down the background volume because you could hear the Twitch?
Yeah, sorry.
No, no problem. So a very, very, very emphatic victory here that you just posted up over the Solus Sabres. I know you and Coach Chase have had words before in the farm. So was this kind of like a good opportunity to give them the business a little bit in a nice, wholesome way?
The thing is, if you play Chase, you know you're going to have an easy win. But the problem is, will you come out of it without any injuries?
Yep.
Because he doesn't care for the ball. You saw that in the game. He just went for all the blocks he could do, even piling on while standing. His elf would have been better for assists, giving assists and stuff like that. He actually did red die blocks because he piled on with his elf.
Yes.
So tactically, that's not very strong, but he just wants to see Mayhem on the field.
I will say that, you know, he does stick to his strategy, right? His strategy is not to beat you. It's not that he doesn't care about winning. From my observations in his matches, is that his strategy is, I'm going to take as many of your players off the field, and then I'm just going to win because you can't defend. But as we know, statistically, that just over time, that doesn't work out. So you really can't just always play like that. And once he ran into a team like yours, where you got a bunch of strong players, I mean, I think it's fair to say you may be the, like, strength-wise, you may be the strongest, the pure strongest team in the league. I don't think there's anybody that has more strength all packed into
one
squad.
I think there's
right?
one team with 3 strength 5 Chaos Warriors, but I'm not sure in the West.
Right. Yeah, but even then, they don't have. I mean, you're rocking with a bunch of Sorai that are 4 at minimum, and then you got 3 guys with 5. So that's, I mean, yeah, but you're up there. I mean, the bottom line is, so if once he ran into a coach that was had a team that was bashier than him, I think he didn't know what to do. He was getting beat up.
But last week he played Tundun and he did pretty well the second half in that game.
Did you watch that one?
Yeah, I watched that one. But the score was still 0-0 then. Thus, I think the moment he sees, oh, I'm behind, I'm not going to win, I'm just going to fall, I'm just going to pile on everything, and just, I don't care about the game anymore.
That's exactly
but, you
what
know, in
I
Blood Bowl,
thought too.
Even if it's a long shot, you still can score.
True.
Like, mini second goal was a long shot. The Disturbing Presence made it a 4+ to pick up and then to go for it without reroll.
Yep.
But I went for it and then he scored. She scored.
Yeah. You never know.
Well, it was
like
a fun
and
entertaining game. But if you're building a team, you don't want games like that. So in the form, I avoid Chase.
Yeah. But this one was definitely fun to watch for us. Hopefully. Was it still fun for you to play, though?
Yeah, it was fun. Of course, if a couple of Strength 5 guys were niggled or one was dead, then I wouldn't have so much fun, but no, I had fun. Actually, when he fought, I was kind of happy that they were injured or KO'd and just barely hurt, because then they were off the field and he couldn't fall them again.
Right. I was thinking that too. So that's why we saw you come over with the Strength 5 guy and start fouling.
Yeah. Yeah, that was the reason. I just wanted him ejected and then he couldn't be fault.
It's so funny how sometimes you just have to completely adjust your strategy on the fly and do things that you normally never do to fit the situation. Now, this was
but
from...
to be honest, I started the fouling. I had a bribe, so I started the fouling with my bribe, but of course, immediately got caught.
Well, okay, so you burned the bribe right away. Okay, gotcha.
Yeah.
And then it looks like he got ejected right away, too,
The ref was legalized today. He ejected almost everyone that fouled.
Five total players were thrown out today.
Yeah.
You know, that might be a record, yeah. I don't remember ever seeing that before. And Chase tied the record with three ejections himself. So, definitely from our end, entertaining as hell. I'm really glad I got to call this one.
Wade didn't perform very well. He only had one injury, and he had an average of 2 per game, so I had to talk with him.
But everybody else stepped up, though. It looked like your team was fired up from last week's loss and came out here swinging.
Yeah. So. Yeah. If Chase had the dice that Pong had last week for the injuries, then I wouldn't have any team after turn 7 or 8.
Yeah. And it's funny because I just went through the same thing with my Lizard team. You know, TMNL got beat up really bad a couple weeks ago by an Orc team, and then last week came out swinging on the Skaven. We didn't win, but we ended up tying, but definitely got the hits in, though. The armor breaks were there, so I guess that's the upside, right? You get beat up, you get the armor breaks, you get some bad die rolls, they come back next week angry.
You always have one such game a season, and last season that was during the playoffs for me. And I hope it's over. And
so now you got it out of the way, right?
Yeah, I can go and win the league.
Nice. All right, well, keep doing your thing, man. It's a pleasure watching you wipe up the pitch with some Norsemen, and good job.
Okay.
You got any parting shots?
Thanks for announcing.
Of course, my pleasure. Anything? You got any parting shots on your way out? Anything you want to say to the audience?
That's more shots. That has parting shots.
Gotcha.
I don't have any parting shots.
All right.
Okay.
All right, everybody. See you, man. We're watching the MML at www.mmlpro.com. This is Sirius Jess, your announcer. We were just talking with Coach Don Eagle. His opposing coach was Coach JJ. This was Leaping Lizard versus Solus Sabres. Check out the website if you think you have what it takes to be an MML coach. It doesn't hurt to just create a farm team, go on the farm, and do your thing. Good job, everybody. See you on the pitch next time.